Again. Step, push, step, step, touch, kick. Again. Step, push, step, step, strong arms. Again. Step, push.
The Words That Move Me community is an assemblage of people who do stuff. We cut a rug, we throw shapes, we trip the light fantastic. We dance. And we made this movie. The Words That Move Me community will henceforth be referred to as WTMMCOMM. For time's sake, and convenience sake, also for funk's sake. Just sounds funky. This film is designed to introduce our governing principles to those who may be unaware, to inspire those who may be curious about creative life, and to ensure the engaged that this is where it's funkin' at. The following will bring clarity and confidence without compromising truth. Clarity that compromises truth is worthless. Confidence that compromises others is arrogance. These 8 counts exist to keep the beat of your experience within the community. Falling out of step with these guiding principles is like dancing off beat. It is unfunky and therefore unacceptable. Count 1. Everyone dance everywhere. This is a community dedicated to supporting all creative types. Discrimination is simply not permitted. We believe in dance for all people, and all places. Dance isn't exclusive to those who were trained, to those who have a stage, or to those who have an iPhone. Dance belongs to everyone, and it belongs everywhere. So as you engage with the outside and the inside world, we encourage you to ask, can I put some dance here? We think you'll find the answer is almost always yes. Field of tall grass. I lay there in the sun and felt it. While many in the entertainment industry are concerned with fitting in, we are concerned with standing out. Not only do we welcome your differences, we celebrate otherness. We champion unusual. We encourage odd. We believe that by rounding off all of your corners to fit in, you'll wind up losing your edge. So stay sharp at all costs. Stay flexible, like a blade of grass in a hurricane. Count 2. Value your work. Dance types may be athletic, but dance is not sports. Don't confuse booking with winning, and don't confuse not booking with losing. Numbers don't determine your value, and neither do other people. Believing that they do is a barrier to making great work and working often. To keep our creative muscles strong, we make creative works daily. We affectionately call this practice doing daily. Hashtag doing daily WTMM. The completion of every creative work is encouraged to be met with a self-evaluation and then released completely. What went well? What would you do differently next time?
And then... there is no scoreboard, so simply play.
5, 6, 7.
Get in order.
One might ask, if there's no scoreboard and there's no winner, then why play? Count 3.
Prefer progress over perfection.
We believe our work is play, and although our work must be taken seriously, it won't help to get too serious in the pursuit of perfection. We believe that perfection is a lovely companion that can weigh in from the distance of the passenger seat.
You mean like what I do?
Well, yes. Here we are, sunset in Camden.
We believe it's better to be memorable than it is to be perfect. Or perfect. Count 4. Feel your feelings. That's what they're there for. Otherwise, they would be called avoidings. For a moment, imagine a world without anger. Imagine a world without panic, or heartbreak, or sorrow, or grief. Now imagine a world without sexy, extravagant, or mischievous. See, we're not interested in a world without those feelings, or without any feelings for that matter. We believe in all feelings. Feelings are the fuel of our work. Feelings are the fuel of our lives. Most people have a misconception that feelings should be good and that we should be comfortable and happy most of the time. Ironically, this idea leads to misery. We believe in the full range of human emotion. We believe our lives will be spent in a perfect bell curve of emotional range. Some really, really good, some really, really bad, but mostly somewhere in the middle. That's life, and we believe we should be prepared for it. Count 5.
Trade confusion for curiosity.
Trading confusion is perhaps the most valuable trade you can make. More valuable than trading a banana for some fruit snacks. More valuable than trading good feet for good turns. And here's why.
Confusion sounds like
I don't understand how I can get everything around me doesn't make
sense.
Where
is this path going to lead
me? Why am I doing this?
And it usually looks like. Whereas curiosity sounds like.
I get to ask big questions and find big answers.
And leads to better. Count 6. Yes and, no but. Saying yes and is powerful because it makes room for new ideas and for growth. No but is powerful because it sets boundaries that protect you and foster respect for your physical and mental self. No but can also protect your time, your money, and your energy. There are many, many options between yes and no. We get to negotiate. We get to advocate for ourselves. Advocating for yourself is funky. Count seven. Just stop using just. If we've learned anything from over a year of weekly podcasting, it's that words matter. So unless being used to explain fair, equitable, impartial, unbiased behavior, as in a just democratic society, the word just is strictly forbidden. One of just's many meanings is barely, as in hardly, or scarcely, or by a little. For example, she just missed the deadline. Did you really barely call to say I love you? Did you really almost email to check in about that audition? No. You are emailing to check in on that audition. You simply called to say, I love you. Just doesn't soften, it minimizes. Just doesn't clarify, it complicates. Just doesn't help, it diminishes. Just is almost never essential. Just doesn't cut it. So cut it out. Even when used as a metric for time, for example, I just saw Tony Basil roasting people half her age. Your statement is still stronger without just. It's just better. It's simply better, undeniably better, indisputably better. It's better without just. In Tom Sachs's 10 Bullets, which is king of visual manuals, bullet number 8 is always be nulling.
A, B,
K.
A, always, B, B.
K, nulling.
Always
be nulling.
Always
be nulling.
Nulling is the act of surveying your environment for materials not in use, returning the unused objects to where they belong, grouping remaining like objects, and then aligning them at parallel or 90-degree angles, either to the surface they rest on or to the room itself. The function of nulling, obviously, is to have everything you need and see everything you have. In other words, to always be nulling is to never stop keeping your shit together, mentally and physically. Here at Words That Move Me, we love keeping our mental and physical shit together. So here, count 8 is always be rolling. Rolling has multiple meanings, of course. We care about 3 of them. Number 1, always be rolling with it, as in life, which is full of ups and downs, especially for creative types. So, to keep moving, we recommend rolling, like a ball bearing, like a wheel, like a circle, which has no end and no beginning, which reminds me, our favorite way to move is endlessly. And our favorite number is 8. Coincidence? Actually, yes, it is. Number 2, always be rolling it out, because knots are not funky. The benefits of foam rolling are not to be underestimated. And finally, number 3, always be rolling, as in recording. Always be rolling, especially if you're engaged in doing daily, and especially if you're not shooting on film, which is expensive. Always be rolling. It's the best way to know what you need and see what you have. And occasionally have some stuff that you don't need also, which is one way to think of B-roll. Always be rolling, which is also a coincidence. A-B-R. Always be rolling. Always.
We did it. That was it. We did it. Good job, everybody.
Cut?
No, don't cut. God, no, don't.
Are you sure?
Sure.
Always be rolling. No, great. Definitely okay. Not. Right. But pack it up.
Okay. Great.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on?
This is the replacement after the.
Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, baby, how do you
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay.